Let's wait for a minute, let other people also join, and we'll get started. So let's wait for a minute, Biswajit, let other people also join, and we'll get started. Yeah, Biswajit, you are telling something?
No, you are on mute. That's what I was just saying.
No problem. Okay, so I guess everyone is back. Let me reduce. Okay, so what happens if you see previous is unclickable and next is clickable? So what happens is as soon as I go for a next page, now previous is clickable. So in this process, what happened is one extra element got added as we go on to the next page. That one extra element and the position of that particular element got added. If I click on the first page, if I go to the first page, this element is not clickable. Okay. And the position. When I say element, position, so let's suppose this is first element. This is second element. This is third. This is fourth. This is fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11th, 12th, wherever it is clickable, those are kind of element classes. Okay. So when I click on this, let's come here. I'll just show you. Okay. So rows, everything done. First page, we are able to scrape. Now we wanted to scrape a second page result also. We go to second page and do a manual scraping. Otherwise, we just go and create a navigation. Okay. So navigation is, we are giving a first command to the system using these rows and column. We are creating a command and we are asking data miner to scrape whatever the details we want. That is the first command. Second command we are creating, we are asking data miner, after scraping a details from the first page, you should go to the next page. That's the second command what we are creating now. First command we have created using data miner, scrape their email IDs, names, title, location, everything. Now the second command we are creating, that is a navigation. After completing the first command, after scraping the data from the first page, we are asking data miner to go to the next page. How to create that? So from the page, we see which is an element which will allow us to go to the next page. So this is that element which will allow us to go to the next page. Now we say find and click on this element. Shift. So element class, next page. Now if you see, it got highlighted in a blue also. Orange dot first. Earlier it was in a highlighted in a orange dots. As soon as we select an element, it got highlighted with orange and blue dots. Element selector, next page. Similarly, what happens if I go to the first page? We go to the first page. We say find. And we select this and shift. Though the element class is next page, but let's see what happens if we select a next page element only on a first page. I'll say confirm. Okay, this we have done. So let's stay on the first page. Remember some of the names, Shivram, K.S. Sriram, Harishankar, Ramesh and all, Paul and Kirtika. Now we say, we directly save it. Come to the navigation part. Now we say test navigation. So now you see it has gone to the second page. Names changed. It has gone to the second page. But now again, if I do test navigation. Though it has gone to the next page, but not really sure. Okay, third page is it has gone. Again, I'll say test navigation. It has gone to the fourth page. Okay, now let's save it. I have saved it. Came to the first page. Closed it. Either I come here. Or I come here. Okay, and we say run. Okay, first page Shivram to Kritika. Then we say next page. Now it's asking start pagination. Always keep on by default, whatever comes, wait for 5 seconds. Before going to the next page, because in that 5 seconds, it will finish up the scraping of the entire page. And scrape maybe 10 pages. I'll limit it to scrape 5 pages. How many ever we want, we can do that. New row scraped from the last page is already scraped is 10 pages. Total rows already scraped is 10 results from each page. Rows and this 10 rows scraped it from the last page and close it. Okay, then I'll say wait for 5 seconds and scrape 5 more pages and start pagination. So first page, it has already scraped it. Now let's see if the page is changing. Okay, third, fourth, it has gone. Fifth, it has gone. Sixth, it has gone. It is here. It's moving to the next page. So we just come to the data miner. Pagination finished. And we say stop. So Srivastam, here is the 6th page result. So maybe in LinkedIn it's really working good. Just the one normal selector is working fine for us. So let me say data miner 4. So now we have here we go. So from 5 pages, it's supposed to be 61, but we have 50. Sorry, it's supposed to be 50, but we have 61. Maybe after the first page, additional 5 pages it scraped. So that's reason it has come 60. The first part is just the name, user, URL, and all. So that is non-countable. So from 61, the first is just the name, user ID, and field, and the additional 50 names. We have scraped it. So it went good, but sometimes you might experience as this particular element has increased here. Okay, this happens. Okay, now if you see, here we had this element, though if we were on a first page, though this is not clickable on a first page, but as soon as we go to the second page, this element was clickable. So though this element was non-clickable, but that element was available that time. So that's reason, just by selecting this particular element, things worked out and the scraping was successful. But otherwise, if you see, if you come to LinkedIn, I do not have that backslash element. I have only forward element. I do not have a backward element. But as soon as I go forward, then that is where this backward element is coming.
So and the X path, that be a problem?
Yes, because that position, this is one extra element is getting added to the page.
Okay.
So if I say here, okay, now I'll say this shift. Okay, so this is not the next page element. Okay, I'll say select. It has selected all the stuff because I do not have an. Now, if you see, a lot of stuff got selected, got highlighted in blue. See here, 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 here. So many things got selected, so many things got highlighted in blue. If I select this, in this also, so many things got selected, so many things got highlighted. As I mentioned, we will use this up arrow wala stuff, then we'll keep on seeing when it is coming. So here, the position is changing, 7, 8, 9, if you see. That those are the element position. Now let me just take you up and try to see where that element is going now. Okay. Have to minimize more. Yes. Now if you see here, here you see this plus has been selected now. So now I'm trying to move that element. So it's going somewhere in order. So maybe it's going down. See here, it has come to the school now. So if you see the left hand, observe here, 54th element, industry, keyword, employment. Can you see my screen? That blue part is jumping one after other, current company here. This element is going field of study. Now it has gone up somewhere. Now it has come here. So at the same time, you can see here also element position 65. Okay, now it is coming here. Okay, let's keep taking. See here, it's coming here one by one. So it will come to next, next, next.
So Shiva, what you are saying is like, it is very important that we should have at least the base elements fixed.
Yes. Okay,
but that as will soon not as, be there with the like
the depends on page to page performance. GitHub has a fixed element, so it did not affect it, our navigation. But different site might not have a fixed element. Mm-hmm. So we're still trying to come to the actual. Now if you see this blue part, 182. Now 183, 184, Now finally 185, it has come, it got selected. Now if I say confirm, okay, and we say test navigation, it's not going anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
But if I go to the next page, and we say find, remove this, I'll take this part. Okay, and take the part ahead. Then now try to, oh sorry, I mistakenly can take this part ahead. Okay, now if we see this two, this all thing got selected, then again we need to keep on hovering. Okay, so that's how we need to come, and that's where this element was going. What is this element selected? I selected from here. Instead of bottom, I selected from here and confirm. That is where, because if I come to the first page, I do not have that additional element. But if I go to the next page, I have that additional element. So there is an increment, EQ1. In a first page, it will be EQ0. If I say again, I'll close this, find, and shift. Okay, this has come. And then we go. We try to get our element class. Doing a lot of various stuff. So that's how this class part has to be changed. That time I was editing the particular stuff. So that's the reason it got in that way. So let me not disturb. So this element was different. EQ1 when I come to the second page, but otherwise it will be EQ0. Okay, so but when I go to the second page, I know now if it is going to third page also, it's going to be one particular element, unless it is a last page. So in this case, it's a last page. So what we do is always, when we do not have that standard elements, what we'll have to do is like create a recipe. Create a recipe, first page extract manually, go to second page and select that particular next page element when you do not see the previous part. And after going to the 10th page, as likewise when we were on a LinkedIn here, when we gone on a third last page, one element again got reduced. So the first page and last page, I am scraping it manually, but in between, whatever the pages are there, with selecting a proper element of navigation from second page to last second last page, I'm screening it automatically. Clear or doubts?
So there are a few questions that I want to ask.
Sure, please go ahead. So this is about GitHub. I'll again come to the first page. I had a standard element here of a next. So that's the reason we are not taking an additional element. List, user items, Then we selected columns. Under the column, we are taking name, user URL, user ID, title, location, email IDs. Then navigation. Navigation is nothing but a second command where we are asking, after scraping the data from the first page, go to the second page. And we have seen which element is letting it go to the next page. On GitHub, it was very straightforward. As soon as we selected this, we find it. We say find, we have selected this element, shift, and there is a direct next page element. So that's reason it is successful. But other sites work in a different way. Let's see. Okay, let's complete this first. And then we say confirm. And after coming here, we do the first test. And we see if in case if it is going for the second page, then I can do a set test again. Then it's coming to the third. So that consistency we are trying to see in case if it is going properly. It's not jumping from 1 to 4, 1 to 5, or 1 to last, or last to first like that. Because the element is fixed over here, and this is allowing it to go one by one. But different pages behaves different ways. So that we need to understand while selecting a navigation, very much important. Now let's suppose if I go here, okay. So it says site GitHub, Chennai, Java. Okay.
Shiva, I think your screen is frozen or something.
Is it?
Let me stop. On the GitHub, some scrapping.
Let me stop and reshare. Now? Okay. I guess it might be your or mine internet connectivity issue, but I don't think so it's mine, but otherwise I'll get the pop-up.
Yeah, I think that it is mine only. It is mine only. But I'm able to hear you completely, but the screen is
Screen is not running. Now you can see my screen, right?
Yeah, then now it is open.
Okay. So tell me if had is... So now you see GitHub page of ThoughtWorks Chennai. I gave an X-ray search on Google. Can you see my page? Biswajit, you there? Okay, meanwhile, someone else has a question. Please ask.
Yes, sir. So I wanted to ask about the columns. Earlier when you were creating this GitHub columns, when you were scraping the data, so there were a few things that I wanted to ask you in the elements section. Can you please go to that page?
Columns, okay.
Yeah. So, not here, I guess. So when you were just finding out these elements, there were a lot of sub-elements that were being asked. So there was like this host list, element, P class. So you were just checking which one were the correct option. So there were three of them I particularly noticed. All of them had the same selection. So what is the difference between all of them?
That's the reason I asked. Pause me immediately to ask a question. This is going to be a bit critical. So once we miss on, I may not be able to understand the question. Okay, let's see. Let's find. Now, which part are you telling? While selecting email ID or location?
Name.
While selecting name?
Yeah.
Okay, let me say shift. Now you say element class, this one. It's selecting all the names, but HTML type, this is selecting name, user ID, and email. If I confirm this, then name, user ID, email, and this profile pic, all will come in one column of Excel. It will not come in different columns. So if this is okay, Excel, here I have a name. Okay, let's do another test now. This will close. We'll create a recipe. We'll say new recipe. List. We say find. We selected this particular element. That is a user list.
Yes, this is what exactly I was talking about. All these different elements, when you were selecting earlier, you were checking which one was the better option for you to
exactly.
Get it. Just wanted to understand what is the difference between them.
Not much. I'll say this item is selecting all the usernames. Let's see what this item. This item is also selecting all the usernames. This is selecting all username plus Chinnai, this and all. So we do not want that. So what I'm trying to get is, we want a particular set which will only select the required profile pages. See, if you see under this one particular entire pages of one object, under one data object, we have, these are the different data objects. These are the different data objects. We have those things. So we want the profile data objects. Okay, so if I click this, this is selecting profile data along with other information that is non-relevant. We don't want that. If I select this, so out of these four, these three are relevant. We can take this, yeah, or we can take this. We can take whichever. Now GitHub page has this way, so we can take whichever. But if you go for LinkedIn, if you go for other pages, other website like Stack and all, may not be, everything would be as simple as GitHub. So this is selecting everything. I don't want this.
That is what I want to understand. Like when you were selecting the user list item or the PV4 or the hit user, all three of them give the same result, same selection. But what is the difference between those particular three ones?
No, it's when it is selecting the same, there is no difference. So if I say, let's say, as it is, the selection is as it is. Okay, so user list item element selector. So that is one way, or dflex, that this is not the way, or py4.py4 element selector, that might be other way, or hit user, this might be other way. So all three are giving me the relevant result what I want. I can take any one of them. So that doesn't
matter. Yeah, why are they showing three different things when all of them are giving the same results?
Maybe the GitHub site is designed in such a way that they have given option. Yeah.
Okay.
So that's reason from three different ways we have a way to get their details. So it's like kind of a open-ended and based on the way they have developed their site actually.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes. So that's about a GitHub. Scraping, we have created a data miner for GitHub. Now let's move for while we X-ray GitHub. I wanted someone who has done more than 100 contributions. Site GitHub, Chennai, Java. One, two, three, four, 10,000 contributions. Okay. In last year. So we have 201 results, 211 results, who has more than 100 contribution in past 1 year. So this give me a fair idea of how the person would be active. So from here, if I scrape the data, I can scrape the user URL, title, additional information. So as the settings of my Google page is to show 100 results per page, so within one page itself, I will be able to go. So now here we see how many elements we have. When we go to next page, is it increasing the elements? Now, if you see in a first page, this element wasn't there, the previous page element. But as soon as I go to the second page, I have an element of previous page. Yeah.
Hmm.
Okay. So that position of that element, the number of that element, that matters. Let's see now. Okay, so let's keep on the first page. Recipe creator. Let me minimize this Google page. Recipe creator. New recipe. Again, the list page results. We go with the row. We go with find. Select the particular column. I'm trying to see which column would give me. Start list and find. So this particular data set or this particular object have user URL title, but I want this all to be, so I'm slowly trying to hover it, trying to see in case if I can get this also. Any one profile page is enough. If I click this, let me see in case if this works out. The entire stuff. Element IDs, no. Okay, now this entire stuff got selected, but we just want the profiles. So if you see on top, that green part is moving. Oh. Okay, now it got highlighted with orange and green. Earlier it was only orange highlighted, now orange and green. But let's see, I'm doing this for the first time. And I assume this is not going to be what we are actually needing. And then after that, we'll modify name as a text. I'll just say everything title, I'm getting it. So shift. Okay, wonderful. All the title got selected. Wonderful, here also. This is also cool. Let me go with first element class, confirm. Then add a new part. So this I'll say user URL as a URL find shift. Wonderful, all URL got selected.
Sir, were you selecting all the names previously?
Those were the title, these were the names, these were the URLs.
No, but you were selecting the entire names, right, from the list?
Yeah.
Okay, but I guess it hasn't selected. I guess.
No, it has selected, na? So first part, this entire green part, if you see, this got selected. Second, we have selected this. Then third, now we're selecting this. Let's see. I'll tell you where we are going wrong, but let me finish. Okay, so now we got user URLs. Confirm. We have name, user URL, add new. I'll say info. Find this info, shift. Okay, now here is a challenge. Okay. Now if you see, all the info is not getting selected. Only one info is getting selected. So in this part, what happens when we scrape a data, only for one person the info would be captured. It would not be captured for all the people. So that's the reason we were trying to select the info part of all the people. No, info part is not getting selected. I'll close this. Again, we see. Okay, contributions. Is this getting selected? Okay. Not all the contribution. The page is not structured or designed in such a way that it would be selecting all the contributions. Let me close. Let me add a new column. Let me close this completely. And then add, like here, all the user URLs got selected. Here, all the titles got selected. Now column 3. Let's see. We wanted only this part to be getting selected in all the user profiles. So I do not have the element. If I'm doing this also, it is selecting only one. I do not have a multiple selector element. Select a pattern. Then we click on select a pattern. Okay, now here it's taking the entire user info. Now let's say element class, yes. Now it's taking first line and the second line. Now this is taking title and all. Then again, as soon as I go, then it keeps changing. So no, I'll just go with this part and see in case, no, only one part will get selected. So I'll just untick it and tick it again. Yes, all the lines got selected. Let's see. And this I'll name it as a info. Okay, so we are on the first page. Now we are coming to navigation. Now we say find the next page element that is next and shift. So it's not giving me the option to click on shift. Let me see this. It's not getting selected. No. Let me see now.